Okay, so. Search the crime scene, bath strain. Find missing weapon number. Suspects are in Scotland Yard. Belongs to the victim and witness array of Scotland Yard. We need. Now, why would it let us look at this if we couldn't really grab anything? Wait. We had something. Box.
A glass plate negative is missing. It is a glass plate negative of an Egyptian statue.
Cool. They murdered him for the glass plate. I have no idea what they did.
Archaeological findings. Old clay pots with numbers inscribed upon them.
Should we take a note of that, or? I mean, don't mind me, you're Sherlock Holmes. I'm just the guy that's with you. So far we have one murdered man, three possible suspects. They were in cahoots. I have no idea. Let's steal stuff.
A shape has been cut in the plate. What should be done with it?
Decorative.
Archaeological findings. Old clay pots with numbers inscribed upon them.
I believe that's... You'd think we'd be able... One of these things on the ground would be a clue, but it doesn't appear so yet. Do we have anything that can grab?
Tools used by archaeologists in their research.
Clamp thingy, majigger, mabobber. Give me that.
Tongs. I will need these tongs.
Tongs. Tongs. Tongs. Tongs. Now we can go... Obtain the one thing. Actually, we should continue onward for a second. As we go somewhere.
God, are you all right? I wonder how this could have happened.
Yes, it is somewhat treacherous. Fortunately, I am unscathed. To where does this corridor lead?
To the frigidarium, the coal room.
Barely unscathed and by a very small margin. And treacherous is an understatement.
Well, that was...
Those stones weigh tons. We won't move them.
Not with that attitude.
It does not matter. If our investigation requires it, we shall ask for them to be removed.
Yeah.
What should we do next, Holmes?
I don't know. Why are you around? I mean, I guess you scribe my adventures, but they're kind of useless, I gotta admit.
All these events are bad for the baths. And my job.
Well... Exit. To Scotland Yard, I suppose. Never want to discuss, maybe Watson, you know, Watson, maybe you'd be some help if you discuss these cases with Holmes instead of just leeching off his popularity and talent.
What should we do next, Holmes?
We should get a new freaking, get a new sidekick. I should go play Jack the Ripper after this game. Got belongings.
This ring was most likely the one that Sir Rodney wore. He removed it before entering the steam room.
Did he also remove the textures? Wait, it's burnt.
I see the join. This ring was repaired, and quite badly too, with silver. An Egyptian symbol. It is a very old jewel.
Why on earth would they wear such a ring?
A very pertinent question. An old and rather dirty coin.
Dirty, filthy coin. Anyway, notebook.
Rodney Bentcliffe's notebook. It may contain something of interest. The last pages were torn out. We must find a way of retrieving Sir Rodney's last lines. Watson, please prevent anyone from entering the room. But first, fetch me a pencil.
How's he going to fetch you a pencil if he can't leave the room?
To begin with, a few strokes of the pencil will be enough. I don't want to damage the traces. And then to gently smudge the leftover pencil marks with a handkerchief. I'm sure that Watson won't mind if I use his.
Didn't know a handkerchief trick with that. That's cool. Today I almost found that this date will go down in history, I think is what it said before it left.
Mr. Holmes, the coroner... But what are you doing? Tampering with the evidence?
I prefer to make them talk. Today, I almost found it. This date will go down in history. Sir Rodney was about to make an outstanding discovery.
Wonderful.
I could retrieve only the final words. The rest of it is lost. Perhaps the autopsy will assist us in that matter.
I'm not sure that I can allow you to inspect the body now.
I am sure that you must, Constable.
Well.
Didn't even get to check out the last thing.
A hand-drawn map.
Okay. Now we've got this one.
An ordinary pencil.
Could be important.
File with herbs. Do you know what it is, my dear fellow?
It's the St. John's wort flower, Holmes. It's commonly used as a drug against melancholia. However, an overdosage might lead to a rash or even hallucinations.
When Garrow found Sir Rodney dead, he wiped the blood upon himself. Sir Gregory Pitkin's visiting card.
A pen.
A fountain pen with solid gold trim.
I would lose it.
An embroidered silk handkerchief.
So that's everything. Yeah, that's everything. Oh yeah, it's the first time we get to look at an autopsy. Who are you? I don't matter. I'm not solving your case.
According to the coroner, there were no cardiac problems nor lung congestion, but there were traces of fungus, possibly contracted from the Egyptian tombs.
Wouldn't it, the scar be required to be cut like in kind of a like a Y shape?
The coroner observed no stomach nor liver disease, if we're to accept that Sir Rodney was an occasional drinker and 63 years of age.
A little editor, I just might start coughing. Ugh. His ass.
The bruising is in lines. Some light bruising caused by a rope. They were caused by a rope around the waist. Sir Rodney was descending somewhere.
Ooh, I wonder if we'll unearth his treasure.
An unusual wound, inflicted by a curved knife, which resulted in instant death, as the coroner's report says.
Why didn't you close his eye? We've inspected the body, found what evidence we could, except for the tong thing, that was an accident.
Please escort this suspect for interrogation.
So we'll get all... We've got three suspects so far.
Good day to you, Sir Gregory. My name is Sherlock Holmes. I'm assisting the police with their investigation of the murder that took place this morning. Would you mind answering a few questions?
Tell me, Mr. Holmes, will I need to stay here for very much longer?
You are the manager of the baths, is that correct?
Yes. I'm passionate about archaeology. I wanted to restore the ruins. My ambition is to open the baths to the public. Living archaeology can be a profitable business, although now I'm not so sure.
I see. When do you wish to begin using the baths?
When the archaeological researches are over, I will be free to complete the restoration. It is the usual process.
What was your relationship with Sir Rodney Bentcliffe?
We were not particularly close. He had an unpleasant temperament, suspicious, authoritarian, unkind. People possessed by genius may be forgiven for their nature, but not by me.
Was he obstructive?
Not at all. Everything he did led us to greater success. He helped us increase the potential of the building.
Please tell me what happened this morning.
The test that we performed this morning was a success. The steam was working well. Then, of course, that awful murder.
What did you see?
The steam was too thick to see anything. But ask Garrow. He saw the body first.
Had Sir Rodney exhibited any recent strange behavior?
Look, I'm not a suspicious fellow, but I think that he had professional interests elsewhere that he did not wish us to know about.
Why should you think that? Where?
I have no idea. But after all, it was not my business.
How was the work progressing before Sir Rodney's arrival?
Rather slowly, I would say.
Sir Gregory, could you please explain this letter? You expressed the wish to call off the research work at the baths.
It was all about Blinkhorn. He was merrily digging away and taking very little care about it, ruining everything and finding nothing of any value.
But the arrival of Sir Rodney changed your mind?
Sir Rodney's work was extremely promising, and it was good for the baths' publicity. So yes, I changed my mind.
Are you aware that Mr. Garrow is under a form of medication?
Garrow? No. But I never liked that parasite.
Do you believe him to be capable of murder?
Well, he did have blood on him. Does that make him a murderer?
Did you bring a bottle of champagne to the baths?
Absolutely not. Sir Rodney did, I think.